Good evening everyone. So we are going to start with a new chapter, that is chapter number 2, which is nothing but the design process. So far we have seen the concepts, the different features, what this exactly embedded system is consisting of. Now let us see how to design the different applications into that embedded system. So moving towards the next point, next slide, we are going to see the embedded system design process. What the process is exactly to follow the embedded system application. So first, let us see the overview of the embedded system design, which is aimed to process into two objectives. The first objective is to introduce the various steps in the embedded system design. And the second one is to consider the design methodology itself. So if we know to design one particular embedded system, there are some steps, there are some rules which we need to follow accordingly so that we are going to get the output into one particular application. So similarly, for the same kind, let us summarize some major steps in how exactly the embedded system design procedure is going to take place. So the next we are going to see that if you see this diagram, which is consisting from top design or the top down design, or you may also consider as the bottom up design. So this various step, which is consisting of the requirements, which is consisting of the specification, which is consisting the architecture, the components, and finally then the system integration. These are the different five steps which we need to follow while considering or while designing one particular embedded system. The first step is nothing but the requirement, as they have told you all. The requirement in means what exactly? The various components, or according to the application what you are going to take, what exactly is the requirement of your application, of your project, that we need to see. Then according to the requirement, we need to go for the specifications. Now suppose if their requirement is, if you are going to consider one particular capacitor, you are going to have one resistor which you are required to design that embedded system for that application. We need to know what are the specific applications for that, what is the specific code for that, what is the specific number you want to get for the capacitor and for the resistor. Then finally you can go for the architecture, then the components you are going to select likewise according to the requirement, and then finally the system is integrated. So according to the diagram which we have seen earlier, this diagram we are going to see in details about this top down design and this bottom up design. So let us see. The top down design will be begin with the most abstract description of the system and conclude with the concrete details. Okay, so the alternative is, for this top down design, the alternative is, we have seen just now, the bottom up design. So we can do the reverse engineering as well. So according to the application, you can go for the components, you can do the architecture, you can see the specification, and then you can get into the embedded systems. So the alternative is the bottom up view, in which we started with components to build a system. The bottom up design, that is the bottom up steps in this, is shown with the upward arrows, as I told you just now. So we need bottom up design because we do not have this perfect insight how later stages of the design process will turn out. Okay, so if we select the top down design, that is with starting procedure of this requirement and then directly to the specification and rest all things, but we don't know if we select these kind of application. For suppose I need to design one temperature sensor application, and for that I have selected these kinds of components and these kinds of architecture, and why system is integrated, I don't know exactly the output is going to get according to my requirement or no, is it not? So to that during the design process, we have to consider three main parameters while designing one particular application, three main parameters has to be considered. The first one is the manufacturing cost, which is most important. Now I need to decide my budget. Why? Because there are number of applications, there are number of manufacturers in which the system. Now suppose, for example, if I need to design a bottle, a simple bottle I need to design. The same bottle, the same design, the same structure can be designed by the another manufacturer as well. But I need to decide. Now this is the simple design. What could be the manufacturing cost of this project? If it is going extending beyond my limit, I need to reduce it to some extent. Okay. So for that, I need to first suggest the manufacturing cost. In that manufacturing cost, I should get the performance. Good performance I want of that particular design. Both the overall design of the overall speed and the deadlines which is going to be considered for that application. And the third one is the power consumption. These are the three main important parameters which we are going to decide while designing the particular embedded systems. So let us see in details about the top design which we have seen in this diagram. First, which one was followed by the requirements. So the requirements may be functional or non-functional. We must capture the basic functions of the embedded system, but the functional description is not sufficient, right? The, according to the requirement, we can have the functionals and non-functional requirements, but that functional requirements is not sufficient to get the particular applications. So we need to go for the non-sufficient or the non-functional requirements. The first one for the non-functional requirement is the performance, right? So the performance, if you consider, what is R or what is the manufacturer going to decide? That whatever the function you are going to take or whatever the application you are going to decide, accordingly the performance of that machine or the performance of that particular design should be excellent. So for that, the speed of the system is one of the major consideration for both the usability of the system and for its ultimate cost. The what the speed the machine is going to give as an output, that is the most important. So the performance may be the combination of software, that is the soft performance of the matrix, such as the approximate time to perform a user level function, and the hard deadlines by which the particular operation must be completed. Now if you consider, for example, the CNC VMC machines. Okay, so if you consider the CNC machine or the VMC machine, in that, to get one particular job, right, to get one particular job or to get the particular job finely tuned in that VMC or CNC machine, it should give the best performance, right? Within this particular time limit, these many jobs should be ready. So that is based on the embedded system, is it not? So for that, what we need to do is the performance we need to consider. Now second thing we are going to see is the cost. The target cost or the purchase price for the system is almost always a consideration. As I told you, what is the manufacturing cost, which is the most important parameter while designing an embedded system? The target cost or the purchase price for the system is always to be considered in two things. First one is the manufacturing cost and second one is the non-recurring engineering cost. Now the manufacturing cost is that which includes everything, right from the components till the assembly part. Okay, this is nothing but called as the manufacturing cost. For example, suppose if you are going to design a machine, okay, mechanical machine. In that mechanical machine, both the parts are, nowadays the mechanical machines are running on automation, right? So that automation is consisting of embedded, that is nothing but the software, as the hardware part is considering of that mechanical things. So to get the output, to get the performance of that particular machine, what are the components you have designed for that hardware part, right from the components till the assembly? Assembly means to combine all the different parts into one structure, is nothing but called as assembly things. So what the things, what is the exact target, what is the exact cost for that is nothing but called as the manufacturing cost. And the second cost is nothing but the non-recurring engineering cost, which includes the personal and the other cost of the designing systems. That is nothing but if you can consider the software programming things in that. The third one. Now, as I told you all, embedded system is a device which should be handheld. Handheld is nothing but it should be easy go carrying wherever you go, right? So the third important part is the physical size and the weight. Nowadays, if you are going to consider the different kind of mobiles, in which the mobiles are totally lightweighted system, in which it is an embedded but it is very lightweight nowadays. The performance are the best, the manufacturing cost is good, and the third one is we need to consider the physical size and the weight. Nowadays, the things which is should be compact and light in weight, the users are in demand, right? So for that, the physical aspects of the final system can be generally or greatly dependent upon the application. Now the physical size and weight is totally depend upon what kind of application you are consisting. Suppose if you are going to consider, as I told you, if you are considering a mechanical machine for a foundry. For example, if you consider a foundry machine, that is a huge application. The machines are so much heavy and so much bulky according to the application if you are going to consider. Similarly, if you want to just design a simple temperature, room temperature project, for that only few components are required. And if you compare a machine with a temperature sensor, it is lots of difference. So compulsorily the application oriented system, it is dependent the physical size and the weight. For example, if you consider, as I told you, an industrial control system for an assembly line may be designed and fit into the standard size rack with no strict limitations on weight. But a handheld device typically has the tight requirements on both size, weight, and can ripple through the entire design system. Next, we are going to consider the power consumption. Of course, the power is most important, and the battery powered system can be often important in the applications as well. Power can be specified in the requirement stages in terms of battery life. Now, most of the things we consider, some embedded system application things are running on batteries. Some can be working on the power supplies. Some are working on both power supplies as well as on your battery life. So that is the most important, the power consumption. Most important thing for the application to run. Second thing is the mock-up. Now the mock-up may be scanned data to simulate the functionality in a strict restricted demonstration, and it may be executed on a PC or a workstation. But it should give the customer a good idea of how the system will be used and how the user can react to it. Physically, non-functional models of devices can also give customer a best idea of characteristics such as size and weight. For this, all the things, we should mock up the system so that that mock-up system can be worked anywhere. On your PC it can work, or it can work on any workstation. And this mock-up idea should be given to the customers so that they can get the good reactions out of the mock-up design. Now, for example, if you consider, so far what we have studied till now, the requirements, the main three major goals to design a system, we are going to see in example with this requirement analysis of a GPS moving map. All of us know that the GPS, that is the global positioning system, is a application in all of the mobiles nowadays, which is just showing you the location. As you move, it is the target is also moving according to you, and it is showing you the exact location. And now this is the handheld device, is it not? This application is in your mobile. So the mobile is a handheld device where you can move the system. Similarly, likewise, the map is also going to move with you all. So how it is possible is that The moving map is a handheld device that displays of the user the map, a train around the user's current position. That map is going to show you the exact current position. Now suppose if I need to walk from a few distance, from my standing position till that particular place, the current position it is going to map first. While measuring that distance, the current position where I am standing and from there, the destination till I reach, it is going to calculate. Right? So the map display changes as the user and the map device changes the position. According to the user, the map display is going to change, and with the help of that display change, the device change its position. So the moving map obtains its position from a GPS, that is the global positioning system, a satellite based navigation system. What is this GPS? It is nothing but a satellite based navigation system. You may see in detail about this global positioning system, how it is working in your satellite communication subject. Okay, so in this figure, if you consider, if you see this figure, actually this is the blurred one, but you can then too you can see, this is the figure where you are going to get the current location, where you are going to get the position, exact position of the user. So with respect to this, the tau, that is a phi, the moving map display might look something like the below figure. Now this figure is going to show you the GPS moving map. So there is the three things: functionality, user interface and the performance. Now the functionality thing is, this system is designed for high driving and similar uses, not nautically or the aviation users that require more specialized databases and functions. Now depending upon the functions where this GPS system you are using, if you are going to use it in for the high targets or you are using just for to get one particular location, depending upon that, the system shows you the major roads, the major landmarks available in your topography databases. Now second thing you are going to see is the user interface. The screen should have at least 400 into 1600 pixel resolution, so that the device should be controlled by more than 3 buttons. And the third we are going to see is the performance, and the map should scroll smoothly, so that upon the power up, the display should take more than 1 second to appear, and the system should be able to verify its position and the display the current map within 15 seconds. Now tell me, within this 15 seconds, the where the location, where the man is standing, where the man needs to reach, where the target is, and the display should also run accordingly, so that it should show the current location of that man or the current location of the human being, and all these things should be appear within just 15 seconds. So for this, what you need to use for the displaying methods, you should use the user interface with high pixel resolution, and for that you should have the good functionality application, that is the good database you should have. So all these things is required: functionality, user interface and performance must required to get all these things. Now second, while doing all these things, again comes to the cost. Now the selling cost, that is nothing but the street price. Street price is nothing but the price which is to be marketably sold, of the unit should be more than $100. Physical size and weight of this should be, the device should fit comfortably and palm on the hand. Obviously, if the system is bulky, no one is going to demand for that nowadays. And third one is the power consumption. Again, we are going to see that that device should run on at least for 8 hours with 4A4 batteries, AA battery sizes. This is what the requirement of a system. Now the next we are going to see is the specifications. The specification is more precise. It serves as the contract between the customer and the architects. The specification should be understandable enough so that someone can verify that it meets system requirements and overall specifications of the customer. Now what is the specification, as I told you? For example, if you buy one dress, right? So what are the specifications you are going to look for that dress? First thing, what is the size of your dress? Second thing, what is the material used? And what is the third thing, and whether it is long lasting or not. As you are paying so much, whether the quality of the cloth is good or no, you are going to observe. What is the size, whether it is going to fit in your back or no, you are going to look. So these are the different parameters what you are looking for a dress. Similarly, for that particular application also, we are going to look for the system specification in more precise way, as it serves the contract between the customer and the architects, right? So whether the demand, whether the user's demand is completing or no, that is wholly and slowly depending upon the specifications. So the specification of the GPS system would include several components, like first one, the data received from the GPS satellite. Second thing we require is the map data, and the third one we require is the user interface. So once you receive the data from the GPS satellite, immediately you can map it with the data which you are having into your database, and similarly with these two references, the user interface, that is nothing but the exact location of your user, can be identified. So these three are the main major requirements. So operation that must be performed to satisfy the customer requests. So background actions required to keep the system running, such as the operating the GPS receiver. UML, a language for describing the specifications. So like the GPS, for example, we have taken a GPS system, we are seeing everything upon the GPS system, how to design, what is the procedure, what exactly is the requirement, specifications, and rest all things. So depending upon this, we are going to use, or to get the data from the GPS receiver, we are going to use a language, that is UML. Next, we are going to see is the architecture design. Now in this architecture design, the specification does not say how the system does things. Only what the system does is the architecture going to tell you all. Is it not? This architecture is nothing but the block diagram in simple, you can call it as. What are the specifications? What is the requirement? This architecture is not going to tell you how exactly the performance the system is going to give. What it is, what the system is, just it is going to define. Okay? So describe it.